Okay, so some people will switch quite a lot in T-cell. So what you'll see is a person attacking and the person will switch, and they'll attack and they switch, and they switch, and they switch. This is very demo style T-cell to me. It doesn't really show you what really can happen because the other person is just feeding a certain pressure. It's okay for training, it's okay for practicing certain aspects of what you want to develop. But in terms of free play, that's not T-cell, right? Because really, when I strike and I hit, if he switches, then I want to de-link and strike him. I don't want to just keep following into what he was doing. Okay, so sometimes that will look like there's a loss of contact or there's no bridge contact. But that's not really the case, because bridge contact doesn't have to be completely locked in with the elbow tight. Bridge contact can be when my pressure is controlling him, right? So when he tries to come forward, he can't move where he wants to move because the pressure is pressurizing his center, right? Some people will say that I'm leaning sometimes because they see pressure clips where my body seems forward. What I'm doing is pressing the hips and waving up through the spine, right? So it's hip pressure through the elbow is a vector force, right? So we're vector forcing with the body, okay? If someone's level or skill is not bad, what will happen is when they press, sometimes I'll drop the weight on them to control their hip, right? This way the spring is sprung. As they push, I can unwind the spring and then strike. So you're using the twisting pressure down, unloading and striking, right? So there's a spiraling pressure. It's not a leaning pressure. Leaning pressure would be kind of dumb. You know, if you're just leaning like this and you're leaning and he moves or moves backwards, I'm going to fall over, right? Okay? It's not. This is a crushing pressure from the second form, twisting down, loading your stance, right? Then unwinding your power. Okay? So there's that crushing, twisting of the stance. There's the vector forcing, which obviously comes through the elbow being in and the hips coming up. Okay? So when that happens, this is where you see a lot of switching. People will switch the hand. They punch, they switch the hands, he's used the angle, which, you know, is walked into my power shot again, right? That's what you don't want. Okay, so from here, when I strike, if he starts to switch, right, he's just walking into more strikes. I don't have to move so much, I don't have to twist or angle, because he's angling incorrectly. So you see a lot of people will angle backwards, the person comes 40 angles backwards, and the angles backwards, so I don't hit. But that's not real. In a real fight, if I'm punching and someone moves backwards, then you're going to chase them forward and smash them. It's not going to be, I'm going to punch and then wait. Then punch, then wait, then punch, then wait. That doesn't happen. Also, that's why we throw the kick, because you have to get used to the idea. If you just step one step back away from my punch, then I can kick you, I can punch you, I can step in, I can move. There's a lot of things that can happen. It's leaving more alive. So, for the Chi Sao and Tagore Sao, or just in Chi Sao even, I want to control the position. When I strike the Lap Sao, the elbow is controlling his elbow, the pressure is controlling his hip. When that punch comes, there's pressure control. So if my switch wants to come in, I don't want to switch here and then just punch empty out here. This might be elbow control, the elbow might be in, but it's not body control. He can do what he wants from here, right? Just because of the line of attack control doesn't mean you control the person. So when that punch comes in here, I want to come in with my hip. So then I have control of his body and control of the power. Right? I'm pushing for training just to test my weight, my structure. But in actual fact, you'll stay with him and stay controlled. Eat the space up and then pound him, right? So you're going to have much more control. So there's a lot of concepts that are based in the principles, but a lot of people have the principles explained in different ways. So you have to take the principle, test it conceptually, and then you have to go back and see whether that works again. So the best way to do that is put gloves on and spar and try it and see what translates into reality. Even though sparring is still a controlled environment, it's still a live environment. So your Chi Sao, you can roll and be more technical and look for your position. Look for your movement, feel the movement. So you sink, rise with strike. Right? You can go into Gore Sao where when you get a crossing hand position, you can play a bit further out. It doesn't mean you're loose, because when he strikes, I still have to control the weight to strike him. Right? Then you can play with your sparring. So here, when you're sparring, you're looking to see which angles are going to be controlled by movements. So even here, angle and change, but I've got to get deep. You know, if I angle up here, I'm walking into his power because he can twist into me. So it's very important that you test the range, right? Chi forms, learn your own structural positioning. Chi Sao, testing your structural positioning. And then application has to be tested with sparring.